109 wins. One is going home. No balls, two strikes. And Flores, did he go? He did! And the game ends! A swinging strike three! Gabe Morales rings him up. The game is over, and the Los Angeles Dodgers are headed to the National League champion
of his generation. I didn't think he went. On the slider from Max, Gabe Morales thought he did.
Boy, what a way to end the game.
That's bad.
I don't think he went.
That's bad.
Can't end the game that way. But it's over. It's not reviewable. It's in the books. Max Scherzer closes it out for the Dodgers. Back-to-back strikeouts to end it.
Roethlisberger on a keeper diving, and does he get there? Yes, he does. The linesman came in. It looked like he was going to spot it. Then he came closer, and Roethlisberger is able to score the touchdown on the 11th play of the drive.
Yeah, I think the way the Seattle defense hit that second down play, I think they had to come up with something like this, where you give them the tailback, you give them the fullback, and then you let the quarterback make the play for you.
And a reviewable play if Mike Holmgren's coaches upstairs tell him that they want this to be challenged. You can challenge this play. You take a look. Does the ball get to the goal line? I take it back about the guys upstairs. This is up to the replay official now, because we're just inside the 2-minute warning. Do the guys upstairs, does the replay official upstairs want to take a look at this? Bill Levy is going to take a look at this because it's close enough. The key here is that any part of the ball goes over or touches any part of the goal line. In other words, the front of the goal line is part of the end zone. And initially it looked as if he was going to spot the ball.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, it's the call on the field.
Rebound, Gensel turned and couldn't fire. Here comes Dumoulin against Hainsey. Cuts in front, scores! Looked like Anderson just about got it. But Brian Dumoulin put the puck in. And what's going to be called here?
I don't think they're going to give him the goal.
They're saying that he pushed the pad over the line. That's something that's a decision that can be made immediately.
There's no goal on the play. Pittsburgh number 8 has 2 minutes. Goaltender interference.
Wow, there's a turn of about. Dumoulin looked like he made a great play. So he interferes with the goaltender in putting the puck in. And instead of getting their first goal, they're shorthanded again.
Well, I think watch the save at the one end by Jari to give this opportunity to go the other. But watch the head of Anderson gets hit right here with the elbow. And I think the puck has not gone over the line there. You can see the reaction immediately. Dean Morton right there is the contact. And then the puck goes over the line. But Jim, boy, when you go back to Monday night and that goal that was allowed when Anderson was upset and hit behind him, and all of a sudden this one, there was no hesitation. Dean Morton put his, waving his arm right away, and Dumoulin goes from excitement to anger as he's hit back in the penalty box.
That was just about a spectacular save. Mike Sullivan is talking to Dan O'Halloran, who's doing all the listening right now. Speaking out on Monday, was lobbying for this all along.
Be interesting to be a fly on the wall on this conversation. I mean, they made their decision, they made their call. You got a player in the penalty box, and maybe Mike Sullivan made some point to Dan O'Halloran that he hadn't really thought of, and said, okay, what's the discussion point here?
Another look at it as Brian Dumoulin cuts to the net.
And the one thing you notice on regular speed, Jim, is just the contact came before the puck went over the line. And there was no hesitation.
Now, much discussion, but not a second look at it.
Yeah, I wondered if he was asking whether he had the right to challenge it. But I think because, Jim, they weren't saying that there was a penalty. I mean, it was an interesting discussion for Sullivan.
There's not a goal. Allard, there's not a goal scored to challenge.
Yeah.
So it's just a penalty.
When it knocks the threes down.
That's it.
I have a feeling you got great joy out of telling me
reporting it. Just reporting it.
Objectively. Just by the tone.
Harden. He was looking for a foul on Bell. Mike D'Antoni upset.
And should have gotten it. I mean, you got to protect the shooter. We saw this all in game six and already one here in game seven.
Call for a second.
You tell me if there's any contact here.
Yes.
Yes.
And the airspace up under also. He got fouled up top and up under.
Troy Brown, Anthony Davis, and LeBron James. 4.1 seconds remaining.
Well, they're going to pin down for James.
James comes up top, gets it. James on the drive, gets in the paint, layup, missed it. And the game is over. Lakers furious. They thought he was fouled. Excuse me. And it's now overtime. LeBron James so upset. Regulation is over. We go to the 5-minute OT. Darvin Ham looks at the officiating staff and says, terrible.
Wow. Clear foul on Tatum.
And there's where, you know, you talked about the challenge, Jeff, not having it after a successful challenge.
Right, but they wouldn't be able to challenge that anyway because it's a non-call. But again, this is exactly why replay was instituted. If we can't review that, then to me, replay.
I'm hoping to make his first impact play and knocking down the quarterback in that three-point stance on 3rd and 19. Lawrence. Young was getting close, and the pass is complete and fumbled. And the Buckeyes pick it up, and barreling into the end zone is Jordan Fuller. They called it a catch and a fumble and a scoop and score. That'll be reviewed, but a potential game-changing play for the Scarlet and Gray.
No, the one question is, was he bobbling the ball, is the one question. That's what they're going to probably take a peek at. Was he bobbling this football, or did he have possession? Okuda, tight coverage.
Ooh, I don't know.
Boy, he's holding on to that football. He has possession of that ball. That's a catch.
On the field with a catch, a fumble, a return for a touchdown. The previous play is under review.
I think he had it long enough, I agree, and Okuda getting that long arm out there. That's why he's frustrated he didn't win the Thorpe Award. He felt he was the best defensive back in the country this year.
Absolutely, and he's very deserving to think that. How about the long arms? We talked all week the matchup, the Ohio State corners against the Clemson wide receivers and the length. Okuda knocks that ball loose, and the safety, Jordan Fuller, right there to pick it up for the touchdown. Here's real speed to give you an idea what they're looking at. Because the ball wasn't bobbled, that's a possession and a fumble in my mind, Bill.
I'm going to respectfully disagree with you. He did not have time to make a football move. When we look at these things in slow motion, you can make anything look like a catch.
Yeah.
At regular speed, he did not finish the process of the catch. I have an incomplete.
Viewers are always confused. A football move.
Yeah, what is a football move? With the ball.
I want to see him turn upfield, take some steps. I want to see him dive. I don't see enough on this turn. When he's hitting, the ball comes out. I have an incomplete pass.
Let's look at this view right here. Boy, I'm glad I'm not in that replay booth making that call. Well, I don't know how you guys do it.
I mean, real
that looks
speed,
like a, that looks like he took three steps.
Real speed, Bill, is very different from replay. This is a replay review. Are you saying they're not going to take into account what it looked like in slow motion?
I want to take and look at slow motion when we're talking about a foot at the sideline or the end line. But when we're talking about the ball's in, he's being hit, I want to see that at real speed.
But again, it was ruled on the field a catch and the fumble. So they have to see 100%
that
it overturns it.
Indisputable video evidence has to reverse it.
What a massive review for this SEC crew. Gerald Hodges and the three folks in the replay center.
After further review, the pass is ruled as incomplete.
They agree with you, and yeah, a massive overturn here.
Bill, good call there. I thought, you know, you look at it again in real speed. Bill makes a lot of great points that I don't understand. I'm not an official. I mean, that looks like a football move to me with taking two or three steps. But, Bill, you make a lot of great points. You understand the rules a lot better than we do. But, man, oh, man, that looks like he has caught that ball and fumbled it. That was a third down play. And
Escobar, another strikeout. Kierzynski is going down to first. The home plate umpire has now made a call and safe, and the Angels are already off the field. The home plate umpire said that ball hit into the ground and that the tag needed to be made, or a throw down to first, or now is he going to bring Kierzynski back to the plate? He's not. Kierzynski is going to go down to first, and Mike Socha wants to know what the heck just happened. Doug Eddings is the home plate umpire, and the Angels were walking off the field.
Well, if Josh Paul made the catch, which he did, then it's a strikeout. Brzezinski's thinking, hey, why not? The home plate umpire couldn't make the call. And this might be the best thing for instant replay in baseball that's happened and occurred this postseason, because clearly he caught the ball, and the catcher knows whether it's a short hop or you catch it cleanly. Whether there's leather between the dirt and the ball.
He caught
that ball cleanly. That's a third out.
He called him out. First of all,
well, he called him out because it was a strikeout. But then Brzezinski ran to first base thinking that he would get the call with the ball in the dirt, and it wasn't in the dirt. Seems to me, we talked about it earlier, that the third base umpire would have the best view. That's Ed Rapuano.
I agree with that. And basically, they should ask the third base umpire to see if so they can get the play right.
Yeah.
Jerry Crawford is explaining. You could see Socha say he put his hand up to call him out. My guys are coming off the field. The ball didn't hit the dirt. Eddings, the home plate umpire, thought it did. And Pierzynski, give him credit. He at least went down to first base, and sure, as you said, sure. Tim, thought, what the heck? I'll give it a shot, try to get down there, and Eddings let him go, and the ninth inning continues.
Josh Paul caught the ball in the webbing of the glove. There was leather, again, between the ball and the dirt. And once that's established, the batter is out, and he does not have a right to go to first base.
It's ruled as a strikeout E2. And Socha has every reason to argue. And Jerry Crawford, the crew chief, who was behind the plate last night, has walked him all the way back over to the dugout.
See, think about it. If Josh Paul didn't make a clean catch of the ball, he wouldn't have rolled the ball back to the mound. He knows he made a clean catch.
Davis up ahead, LeBron in chase mode. LeBron on its way. Got it! He's got it! LeBron.
They're going to review it to see if he was behind the line.
Whoa!
They're going to review it to see if he's behind the line.
They're calling it a two.
They're calling it a long deuce. That's what they're doing, calling it a long deuce.
Oh, LeBron. What a sequence.
First catches up with it. Does he get behind the line?
This is close. And remember, the call is a two. Austin was very close.
This will be a good angle.
Here we go.
He's behind the line. Oh, I don't know. When he turns his foot a little bit,
his
toe hit the line.
Yeah, that might be a good call.
As he was going sideways, he was okay.
Yeah.
But when he turned to square that shoulder up a bit,
yeah.
Smart basketball.
On the floor stands, 2-point field goal.
Oh, there it is.
LeBron is telling him, look with my feet. LeBron saying, look, it's right there in front of you.
Wow. And for what LeBron is looking at, I completely understand his point.
Yeah, because is that in the shot?
Look at that.
Oh, now that, you see how you zoomed in?
That looks like a three.
That
looks like a three.
Oh, boy.
Yet they looked at it, conferred, and the call stands.
It does not have a left-hander on its active roster. That's a tough play for Peacock. And safe at first. Ball gets away, and the runners will advance to second and third. And now they're going to call the runner out for being inside the line and in the way of the throw. And we're going to get an argument now as Dave Martinez is furious. Sam Holbrook, and now the crowd is realizing this. Sam Holbrook has called the batter out for interfering with the throw. Let's take another look.
You can run in this spot. You have to veer back towards the bag. And that is a tough call. He was inside the bag all the way to the end.
But I mean, he's right on it. And we've seen this time after time, regular season, postseason. And Turner is called out. It sends Gomes back to first. I mean, this is potentially a series changing call. It's powered by Mitel. Tom Verducci is with us down at the field level. Tom, what are you hearing down there?
Yeah, this is all about impeding the fielder's ability to catch the ball. It doesn't matter if the throw takes him into the runner. Did the runner impede the fielder's ability to catch the ball? Now, I think Davey Martinez's argument is that Trey Turner, by rule, is allowed to be inside the line for his last step. Think about it. Even if you're in that running lane, you have to come back towards the bag to literally touch the base. And the runner does have a right to the base on that last step. It's all about the timing, the way the umpires see it.
As Drubal Cabrera is trying to calm Trey Turner down, as he has been called out by the home plate umpire. Meanwhile, this umpiring crew, and the crew chief is Gary Cederstrom, and the man who made the call, Sam Holbrook, the home plate umpire over there, talking to New York. And this delay has a stadium full of people wondering what in the world's going on.
This play was made because Turner's speed is so great.
And they're going to stick with the call. Trey Turner can't believe it. And like you said, he's going down the line. His last steps. I may have overstated earlier with regard to him being on the grass, but for the most part, I mean, you see runners way more inside the line than this. He's on the grass with his left foot here, but as he goes to the bag, he's right down the center of the bag. This is between innings. And Dave Martinez went out. And then this escalated where Chip Hale had to hold his manager back. Davey Martinez has been through a heart procedure in the second half of the season. They're trying to get him to take it easy. Then he's thrown out of the ball game.
In a situation you just hope doesn't affect him with what he's been through.
To do that or what? Still looking over.
Oh, yeah.
At the down. You're right there, Larry. He thinks he did it on purpose.
Backhanded by me, and all will hold on to that. Wasn't that Daniel Alfredson in the playoffs?
What do we got? What do we got? Oh. What do we got? The referee and the linesman are conversing.
Red Wings are saying it's in.
The Wings think it's a counted goal, and four linesmen and referees are conferring about what happened. Where's the puck? Oh, my goodness. Look at this. There it is right there. That's in the net, and the whistle hasn't gone.
Here we go. Let's listen.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Here we go.
There is no goal on the play.
Oh,
the whistle
boy.
Is blown to kill the play.
Wow.
Oh, that's unbelievable.
Wow.
Wow.
And he couldn't have. It was a couple of seconds.
Number 42. Blitz. Lost the football. It's on the ground. Covered by the Raiders.
His college teammate, Charles Woodson, on the blitz. Tom Brady never sees him coming from the front side. Greg Beekert recovers the fumble. Charles Woodson, first time today I've seen him come on a blitz.
Oh. The question is, did he pull it down? His arm was going forward, but was he throwing a football?
Well, the exact term I can't think of, but if you throw a pass, and as you're faking that pass, now watch, as you're faking the pass, if it slipped out of your hand, that would be an incomplete pass. But was it forced out by Charles Woodson? I don't think the recoil of the fake throw is what made it come out of Tom Brady's hand.
After reviewing the play, the quarterback's arm was going forward. It is an incomplete pass. Second and 10 on the 42.
Wow.
20 seconds left to go. Flames changing behind the play. Zafrikin's great speed springs him in.
Off the glove, the stick and glove of Javi Bullock.
He kicked it out. The rebound carried back. He got it with his right foot. Yep. Sensational save. I kicked it out.
Off
watch the
skate.
Right skate.
And oh my gracious.
That puck might
oh
be
my
in.
Gracious. It
that
went across the line. It and absolutely is in.
Because of our replay work. Look at the spotlight. The puck will go over the line and hit the goal pad.
Got to keep it going right there.
It's over and then back out. And I don't know if anybody realized it, but our crew,